The Triple B Podcast would like to invite you to come break bread with your brothers. If you like what you're hearing on the show, if you think we missed the mark, or if we got it all wrong, reach out to us on social media. We can be reached on Twitter at @triple_B_pod or search Brothers Breaking Bread Podcast. We are the Brothers Breaking Bread on Facebook, and our email is brothersbreakingbreadpod@gmail.com. Further descriptions are in the show notes. Like, follow, friend, do all that good stuff. And please, never forget to break bread with your brothers.
Hey, so you familiar with Skype?
I'm a little bit on it. What I need to know.
Well, as a homeboy got up, man, you just need to know how you work that mute button. Man, really? This nigga be having problems with it, so.
Nah, I know how to work a mute button.
Okay.
I'm good. I got that.
You ain't got no like industrial shredder or nothing sitting by you. You ain't about to start pissing in the middle of the show, nothing like that.
I mean, yo, I can't help it if I live in the ghetto and
How y'all doing? We out here chilling in the spot. What up?
How y'all doing? We out here chilling in the spot. What up?
What's going on, y'all? Brothers Breaking Bread Podcast in the house.
Hey! Dude, we're having a little pop-up. It'll be good.
Yeah, let's make it happen. Let's not just talk about it. This is a beautiful thing, man. It's all this blackness, and we all just getting together, playing dominoes, eating, drinking.
And, you know, food is always just the extra, man.
To deprive these people of their basic human rights, you know, and we call ourselves Americans. We're supposed to be above all this.
They'll fake the crisis. They'll make it seem way out of proportion.
Brothers, we breaking bread.
How y'all doing? We out here chilling in the spot. What up?
Trying to hold it all together, man. Life is moving fast right now,
man. So it's good to have everybody come through.
I love that, man. I love it a lot more than I could say to you guys.
Oh, speaking of white privilege,
and that's what we're alluding to.
Team, so we're moving on to our sports segment here. Green Bay, and if y'all been under, I know we know it, but some of our listeners may not, you know, watch sports. There's a white guy named Aaron Rodgers. And, of course, there are other members of the NFL in other major sports who are not vaccinated. That's their right.
True.
That's fine. I'm not one of them people, you got to do it. But this goes far beyond that because and Aaron Rodgers says he didn't lie, and there are people who are providing, Stephen A. Smith, who are providing coverage for him to say he didn't lie, but he did definitely misled people to believe he had been vaccinated. He put forth all this medical, he gave 500 pages of a different treatment that he gave to NFL officials who said, no, nigga, you ain't vaccinated. But he was still showing up to these press announcements wearing no mask, which you're supposed to do according to NFL policy if you're not vaccinated. He was still walking around in the Green Bay facility, other facilities when he was going to play away games with no mask on, which you're supposed to do according to NFL policy. So the motherfucker basically was, I'm going full-blown white man. Not only am I not getting vaccinated, I ain't following none of the fucking protocols for people who are not vaccinated.
Right. So in other words, putting not only his teammates, but other teams in jeopardy of contracting this damn virus because he don't want to do what he's supposed to be doing.
And I wish y'all didn't know. I know y'all read, so it's a dumb question to ask. So maybe y'all don't know. So do y'all know? I guess it's right there, too. But let me cover that up. Do y'all know the amount of fine amount for this nigga?
It was $14,600+.
Yes.
For his fine.
In the Green Bay football team, they were fined, I think, $300,000.
Right.
Yeah.
Wow. So, yeah, it was less than $15,000 for him for lying about his COVID vaccination. But other motherfuckers got fined as well.
I just want to put this into, hold on here. Oh my God, my kids are yelling like they have never. You put it in the contract. I'm trying to find, there we go. So Rodgers, 14,000 and some change, right?
$14,650, right?
Yeah. Right. That, I mean, to us, that seems like a little bit of money, but this nigga signed a multi-million dollar contract.
Yes, he did.
A one-time fine, that's a trip to Whataburger.
Yeah, one-time fine. Yeah, right. So, right. And put it into context of why people are confused and so upset. You got CeeDee Lamb, Cowboys wide receiver, had his jersey untucked during the game. He was fined $20,000.
Was that from the NFL or was that part of his team fine as well?
Let me see. NFL priorities, Lamb.
I think that's more of an NFL.
I think fine. NFL. Yeah, I think it was. I'm going to say I think it was NFL, but don't quote me on it, homeboy.
Right, right. No, it's all good. It's all good.
Oh, no, that's a good question. That's a good question.
You know, Jerry Jones is a part of that cult. So.
Yeah, he part of the cult. Yes, he part of the cult. And once again, man, I'm vaccinated. I'm not one of these people where it's like, yeah, you got to get vaccinated. But if you're not vaccinated, don't lie about it for sure and definitely follow certain protocols. I mean, like, Lamar Jackson, not vaccinated. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But he followed the fucking rules. He got the mask on. Mm-hmm. He do what he's supposed to do.
Yeah. I don't understand why. Because he lied on camera, though, bro. He, like, they flat out asked him the question. They're like, so you're vaccinated? And he looked. He you know said, how you do that little side look? He's like, yeah, I'm vaccinated. Next question. Like, he did.
So he said he was in an interview. In he said he was immunized.
He was looking up into his left brain for the answer.
Yeah. Yeah. He did a sleight of hand. Yeah, he didn't say he was vaccinated. He said he was immunized. Yeah.
Okay.
So he did a sleight of hand, and then people are also trying to put this on the media for saying, why wasn't there a follow-up question to say, what does that mean? Because I asked you if you were vaccinated, and you follow, and then he gave that kind of look, too. I'm immunized. It's like, what the fuck does that mean?
Right, what does that mean? I mean, you were immunized when you came out the womb. What are you talking about?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. There's you know, natural, you know,
flu vaccination.
From your mammy and all that good stuff.
You got the vaccination. It was the flu vaccination. That's what it was.
Let me ask y'all a question. Do y'all think that the media didn't know?
Well, he's already said it on his Rogan. I do think there are members of the media who knew and withheld. I do.
Okay.
But
okay. Oh, yeah, for sure.
Because there was another podcast I listened to. They're talking, and we see it all the time. And I'll play a clip with us, my favorite person, Stephen A., to show that media has certain bias to certain athletes. If they fuck with you, they will do all that they can to make you be the golden child. If they don't fuck with you, everything you do, Cam Newton, everything that you do will be put on a microscope and you're going to get fried.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's something that goes on in every camp, every, you know.
Oh, yeah, every sport has their goals.
He does bad. We're going to cover up the bad for a while because he's a great guy, great athlete, but we're going to cover it up. But once, let's just Sean Watson. But once it's time for him to leave or he want to leave, boom, throw it out there. Now, I ain't saying he absolved me. I don't want to change subject. Like, dude, ain't something wrong with him. But you know, they've been knowing certain things for a while. So I think the media is out, especially your hometown media.
Oh, yeah.
They know everything.
And I believe there, you know, ESPN, there are certain networks that say they're just certain guys you can't fuck with because they when they faces are on there and when they playing football games, they drive up business.
Yeah.
All right.
You know, and then, like, you put in contract, like, at work, I was talking to someone. We're talking about Big Ben and Odell Beckham. You think it would be Odell Beckham's the one that was raping white women and stuffing them in the bathroom the way the media treats
him? Oh, yeah, of course. The way he acts. Yeah. Right.
I mean, like, one thing about this, I mean, I think everybody's talked about it. I don't think people put enough context on home. The shade that he threw at Kyrie Irving, talking about I'm not one of these flat earthers or anti-vaxxers. Like, wait a minute, homie. Like, what's that got to do with anything?
And Kyrie Irving has apologized and said he was wrong for that, but nobody wants to talk about that. He said
he shouldn't be talking about Kyrie anyway.
No, no, I agree with that too.
Standard that's going on with that though, like the whole double standard with the two different leagues that's going on with that. Like, there's no uniformity in any of it.
No,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like, yeah. Yeah, there's no uniformity in anything on what they're doing for professional athletes, for these professional buildings. Like, there's no uniformity in what they're actually asking them to do with, you know, Kyrie not even being able to go into the Barclays Center yet. The rule, because the rule is anybody who works in the Barclays Center or is lives in New York and is coming to the Barclays Center or doing that for a facility or anything, anybody comes in, they have to show vaccination, proof of vaccination. Sure. But the caveat is if you are coming there for work from an outside entity, as long you can come in and work.
Yeah.
And that's why the players can come in and play. Yes, I'm sorry not to cut you off. I.e. Bradley Beal, like you, for an example for you, he's not vaccinated. He's a big, I don't want to take it, this and that, which is fine. It's cool. But he can come into New York and have 51 points. You see what I'm saying? Against Brooklyn if he wanted to. But I think a lot of this is new and fluid, and it's a lot of money. Like, hey, we just need to hurry up and get these fans back in here and let's get this money back here. Because honestly, me, I be looking at some of these games, especially the next game when I see the great Jay-Z. Where is his mask at? Everybody behind him and on the side of him got masks, but the great Jay-Z don't have to wear a mask. Like, what are we doing here?
Yeah. And not to go off to like conspiracy theory world, but you know the real reason why they be frying Kyrie Irving? That nigga was gonna cost them money because he was saying when they had that bubble shit going on in the protest, Kyrie was the main one saying we shouldn't play. We should use this as our voice.
And that's the reason why I'm not so big on saying, hey, this is look at what Aaron Rodgers did and look at Kyrie Irving. I don't think those situations are the same. I think Aaron Rodgers is like AC put it, we got two different leagues going on. They're gonna set their own set of rules and it's gonna be different. Right. So that's gonna be an issue. One in the NFL, one in the NBA. But the other thing with Kyrie is that he has a history of wanting to be engaged in work stoppages for reasons that are baffling. And this just looked like another one in the line of wild shit that he was in the middle of. You know what I'm saying? Well, like, if this was the first time, like this is the first time for Aaron Rodgers. If this was the first time for Kyrie, maybe the energy is different. But that's like at least the third time where this nigga just vamped for no apparent fucking reason. For like a series of weeks. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Here's my thing about that. In my opinion about that, there's some of them are baffling. But who is Jane Doe to tell me at work whether I make $17 million or $17,000 that I got mental issues?
He need to keep getting his check need to come regardless.
Hold on. I'm asking though. Who is anybody else? Just because I didn't put my business out there and tell you why that I got to miss work for the next 2 weeks. Like, what if my sister was going through something? God forbid. What if my little sister got raped or something? But it ain't nobody's business for me to tell that to. So mental health, I know people dance on that, but that shit is real, especially to a motherfucker that already came into the league kind of mental. You dig what I'm saying?
I hear what you're saying. I think the contract is set up differently. I think, one, you don't have to give a press conference as to why you missing. Secondly, you have days built in, you know what I'm saying? But they have a series of, 81 work days where they're expected to be there, you know what I'm saying, or be accountable for it.
Yep.
And I just think that's a different paradigm than you and me working, you know what I'm saying? So
I think he's just a nigga that's good at basketball that can live without basketball. Now he's got enough wealth where he can. I think he's at the point where take it or leave it. And niggas don't have to do it. If he okay without playing basketball, niggas don't have to be okay with this nigga not playing basketball. That's what I'm saying.
See, on Joe's defense, what he's saying, I understand what he's saying. Because when this first came out, I told some of my boys, hey, man, they need to give him the same Cam smoke that they gave Cam. I didn't even go to Kyrie until, you know, Stephen A. or Jay Williams brought it up. I wasn't even thinking that because it is two different leagues. They do have two different sets of five different sets of rules, whatever. But he should have got at least some Cam smoke, even some Beasley smoke. They were smoking.
But Beasley was saying some wild shit, though, too, though. That nigga was on Twitter talking crazy.
Hey, that home remedy that Aaron Rodgers is trying to get.
Oh, no, no.
Wild.
No. I'm saying now, like on the back half now with Aaron Rodgers, some of the shit that he was saying, some of the taking the dewormer shit, talking about Kim, that shit he talked to teammates about chemtrails and all kind of crazy shit. That shit's coming out now. But yeah, but Beasley was like really out there on some, you know, and I get it. He's a religious person, but he was like, my Lord and Savior got me. I don't need the vaccination.
Okay.
So, and I'm glad you brought that up. And what we were talking about too. So same league, two different athletes, both of them not vaccinated. Let's see. We'll see what they got to say.
Back position. That's the reason they have
my bad.
The number one.
And I'll set this up. This is Stephen A. talking about Lamar Jackson when it came out that he wasn't vaccinated.
Back position. That's the reason they have the number one rushing attack. And considering how valuable and how important he is to the success of the team, to sit up there and not do everything he could to get himself, to insulate himself from potentially spreading the vaccine or even capturing it himself to some degree is mind-boggling to me. And I just think that it's incredibly alarming that he says he's 24 years of age and he says, well, I got to talk to my teammates. Well, where the hell have you been? Have you not been talking to them? What have you been doing? And your point about all the other stuff that they put in their bodies that they're not even aware of, but suddenly you need to know everything and all the ingredients about this vaccine when throughout your professional career, your collegiate career, this stuff injected into your body that you didn't have, you had limited knowledge about. I mean, give me a break. Come on, man.
Stephen A.
It's ridiculous.
Okay. That's Stephen A. talking about the homie Lamar. Talking about Aaron.
Table, starting with you, your reaction.
Well, it's unfortunate. I mean, you know, it's not major. It's 7-1. If they were to lose the game to Kansas City, which, by the way, I'm not sure they will. We'll see what Jordan Love's made of. But in a typical game, they'd be 7-2. Worst case scenario.
Let me pause right here. Whoever does the camera angle should never have this camera angle on this nigga. This nigga look like the brain. Anyway.
You know, that's fine. But he, you know, he just out because he got the Rona. I mean, he got the Rona. He came down with the Rona. Hanging around with the wrong team, probably Pat McAfee.
Table, starting with you.
Oh, it's all right. He just got the Rona. It's all good.
So,
I mean, same sport.
My first problem with that is his tone talking about the two different topics. It's the same subject matter, yet you're talking about them in two different tones.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that shows a microcosm of how you view both of that. You're viewing the athletes differently before you even, you know, discuss the topic, which is the same, which to me is what everybody else is doing.
Yep. Yeah. And I'll say I won't lie, I have a Stephen A. bias. I don't like that nigga. I think he always got all the smoke for black athletes, and he toned it down. And I get it. He got a master answer too, and they probably told him it's okay to talk shit about these certain athletes, but the other one's off the table.
And what I was gonna ask, is that necessarily the case, or does we just feel like that's the reason? Could it be that this nigga's biased, but it could just be that he likes the style of play of Aaron Rodgers versus Lamar Jackson? Does it have to be based on race?
I don't think so.
I don't know if it's ESPN.
He's what?
He's the Candace Owens of ESPN.
I think that's over the top, like a motherfucker, man.
Listen, I think this is just my opinion. With me, I don't even care about race when it comes to Stephen A. He's become a character, so it's time for me to leave him alone and find a new, better person. Just like Shannon Sharp, I love Shannon Sharp, but once you become a character, you know what I mean? Like, so to me, Stephen A's blackness shit over there, that was a long time ago when he tried to do all that. This here, I think, is like you said, James, I mean, Joe, that's his boy. You know, he root for him and all that. I think it's the play thing. Me and Bosco got into an argument discussion about why I don't think Lamar, you know, that's just my preference. I don't want him as a quarterback. Now, he's proven me wrong. But, I mean, I think it's what you said. I think it's more of a, see, Stephen A. tries to turn these things back into a sports thing. You know, like, when Jay Williams called him out, he turned it back into a sports thing. Well, he missed some time last year. Man, this don't have nothing to do with that, man. How you talk talking about this dude and how you talking about that dude is two totally different things, man.
Yeah.
I just think we're quick to jump to race on everything. Some shit's about race. But I think sometimes we get so hypersensitive to race that we assess other bullshit.
Yeah.
Under the umbrella of race.
I'm a hypersensitive.
Not to say it's not bullshit.
No, I'm not hypersensitive. I just seen countless times where this nigga got all the smoke for black athletes, and then that nigga got the soft shoes on when it comes to white athletes.
Yeah, and all I'm saying is that could be coincidental.
It could be coincidental. Okay. So you tell. So if that's your.
I'm just answering. I've not done the research.
I'm just answering your question. Let's say Aaron Rodgers is his boy.
Don't fall for it, Joe.
Let's say if Aaron Rodgers.
I'm not going to answer.
I'm just saying if Aaron Rodgers is his boy. You don't got to answer. I'm just going to make a statement. Aaron Rodgers is his boy. He should have at least the audacity to say Aaron Rodgers should have done everything to stay there for his team the same way he did for Lamar Jackson. At bare minimum.
In his mind, that's probably what he was doing. In his mind, that's what Rodgers was doing. He probably felt like Aaron Rodgers was lying to stay on the field.
So then you should have more smoke because he's lying.
Sammy Davis Jr.
Okay. Anyway,
No. That's why Max is off that show because Max would have thought he was Sammy Davis Jr. See, yeah. In his mind, he's whoever the hell he want to be, which is why he pulled us and got us thinking, damn, why you ain't do it like that? I mean, he's a character, man.
I get he's a character. I'm just saying, I've never liked the nigga. I mean, that's just me. So, I, as always, I put my agendas out there.
Yeah, I just think he's a fallible human, like we all are. Because I know we've all shown our biases on the show. Go back and check the tapes.
I know, but then I also try not to make the same mistake over and over again, which this nigga keep doing.
But it ain't no mistake, though.
That's what I'm saying. That's why he ain't fallible. It's a paycheck. He do it on purpose because he get paid to do it. That's why he's one of the highest paid black sports analysts out there. Or voices or whatever the fuck he's categorized now. It pay. Like, and we said on this show, Check the Tapes too, don't nothing pay like shaming niggas.
We have said that.
Yeah.
We have said that. I don't know if Stephen A.
What'd you say, AC?
I said it is a job that will never go away. It's
been never go away.
1800.
Because he also called Kyrie Irving. He also called Kyrie stupid and all kind of shit. So, I don't know.
Kyrie thought the earth was flat, nigga. I don't know, man. Come on. Kyrie gives us. We can't do this shit in isolation. Kyrie has done a lot of shit, bro.
Yeah, he's also done a lot of good shit for the black community, too.
He's absolutely done that.
Yeah.
It all has to be taken in context. He's a complex individual.
And he also said, I apologize. I should not say what I said when it came to the earth is flat. So you said fallible human. He apologized for his fallacy, right?
Okay. I do anything.
Okay. Because you said he's fallible. We all make mistakes. He made a mistake, and he apologized for it. But we brought it up.
It's a mistake. But a mistake for who? If that's what that man believed, that's what he believed.
He said he doesn't believe that. He should have never said it.
I mean, who? I didn't give a fuck. That's what the fuck he think. Shit, I know niggas that think AIDS ain't real.
Wow. Like, well, stay away from him.
Hold on, bro. I've been on the front lines. You can't say AIDS ain't real. I've been on the front lines, dog.
I'm just telling you, man, if you talk to different people, bro, you will notice some stupid-ass conversations. But if that's what they want to believe, I'm not getting ready to try to change your mind.
All right. So we'll move on. Aaron Rodgers, he'll be okay. He's still starting for my fantasy team. Anyway. Oh, okay. What'd you say?
He playing tomorrow tonight too, ain't he?
Tonight. Yeah, he's playing right now.
Oh, okay.
He's playing right now.
He has 53 yards in the first quarter.
Let's see if he wears masks today.
Of course not.
Probably not. Anyway. Yeah, I'm gonna talk about the Astroworld first, or get into this Kanye West thing first.
Let's go to Astroworld. Get that over with, man.
Damn.
That was a big tragedy.
Sad. That was sad, man. Sad. I have questions on both sides, but it's sad.
Mm-hmm. Let's say in this week, since Houston Music Festival turned deadly, questions have emerged about who should be held accountable for the 9 people. Oh, damn. So did that little boy finally end up passing?
Yeah. No, it's another girl too that just passed the other day or something.
The boy survived?
Which one?
The girl that got dropped on the head. the one that was getting carried by the ambulance, and they ended up dropping her on her head. It was a video of that going.
Yeah, I know there are 9 people that are dead. They've already had down here. They've already had 2 of the funerals, and then they've had 2 of the funerals from 2 people from Illinois.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So, with it, it's a lot of moving parts, man, to what happened down there, man. Just looking at it from a local perspective, like what happened down there, man. It's first of all, they weren't prepared for that many people, which I don't know how, because they were like. I don't know, maybe by the middle of the morning, they said before this performance even got on stage, there were so many people hurt and so many people using ambulance, like the ambulances and all the emergency services were already in use before the concert even started, like any performance ever got on stage. Like that had already happened. And then just like looking at some things there, who's in charge of, you know, there are 4 or 5 people who are directors, you know, directors of interior security, directors of exterior security. All these people are non-licensed to do those jobs. They were not licensed to do those jobs.
Yeah, I guess I've heard a couple of them things. Like, yeah, they were like way understaffed. I think they cut a lot of corners, but like you said, you don't know how that could happen. This ain't the first rodeo for Astroworld, so I'm with you. Like, y'all should have been better prepared for this, man. You know, I think everybody. I don't know really Travis Scott's music. I'm not a real. I can't tell you nothing about that besides a couple of songs.
I like his one album.
I hear he has some lyrics about mosh pitting and he wants to see somebody. You know, which I'm not gonna say. But a lot of people got certain lyrics, but I'm hearing that this is like kind of what he, in his music wise, I don't know about live, but in his music.
No, he does that. He encourages that. Like, but ever since they had that incident a couple of years ago, maybe 3 or 4 years ago, they had an incident somewhere. He's not encouraged the mosh pit stuff anymore. But yeah, it used to be big with the mosh pit stuff. Yeah, that.
Wow.
I mean, yeah, and I think that's just like, yeah, I mean, we hear about rock and roll and rock concerts. And it's, you know, we never really hear about that being a part of hip-hop, I guess, for the most part. So I think that's another big reason why it's such a shocking thing to hear this because, you know, Travis Scott considered a hip-hop, performer. And to hear about a mosh pit at a hip-hop concert, I know to a lot of people, like, what the fuck?
Right. Yeah. It's unheard of.
But you got to understand that the difference is, when we were listening to hip hop, it was majority. It was us. It was guys. It was kept by us. Yeah. Everybody who's listening to Travis Scott. Travis Scott has a worldwide audience.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. So he's got people coming from all angles, all races, all cultures, everywhere, coming from everywhere. So you know that's gonna be a little different how they move and react in a concert setting. You know what I'm saying? So like each of them is gonna behave differently. Like I just feel like, from what I'm seeing down here, like there was a structural breakdown.
Oh, yeah.
Because you had over 100,000 people in that area, which was, you know, at the end of the day, that's not a large area for 100,000 people to come into and all try to cram into one section as soon as Travis Scott hit the stage. You know what I mean?
Right. And what I had heard was they had like 750 security people. So I guess the motherfuckers calculated that as to 1 security guard every 200 people or something.
Good luck.
Like, that's just not going to work.
But they had multiple security. They had multiple security agencies here. So it wasn't. I mean, it wasn't just one security company overall unit. They had multiple security companies here working it. But several of those security companies, from what they reported, were not even licensed.
Yeah. So you're talking about a breakdown of communication too. You got several different agencies, and if there's 2 or 3 that they're not even like, we don't fuck with y'all because y'all not licensed. That's horrible security, dog. Because no one's you know, the left don't know what the right's doing, and that's how shit gets rushed and motherfuckers get trampled.
Exactly. And I got a question: was that an all ages concert?
It was. It's open to the public because it's not just a concert. They got rides. It's like, you know, it's like a carnival that leads into a concert.
Okay. So that's where the 10-year-old or not, because I'm wondering myself, what are they doing at a concert? What are those kids doing at a concert? Okay.
They're there with parents and everything, and it's like because the whole point of the Astroworld joint was to recreate the amusement park that he grew up with here in Houston, Astroworld.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So
the point was
to recreate that, so you have the carnival all day, and then it leads into, you know, the concert at night when all the artists come on stage.
Gotcha.
Nice.
Okay.
I mean, well, not nice, but I mean, it's nice. It should be nice, but
that's a nice concept, but it turned out tragically.
So I'm guessing.
They did it 3 years prior, so the 3 years prior, there was no incident.
Right. So I'm guessing the 9-year-old boy, they said he was in a medically induced coma, reading that. And I don't know about the younger girl that you guys are talking about. There was
I heard she died like Friday.
Somebody have been the knife victim. I know originally there were 8, so she might have been the 9th victim. That's just crazy, man. That's crazy.
Well, they said the 9th victim was a 22-year-old college student.
Oh, yeah.
Who died on Wednesday.
Okay. Well, maybe she died.
Could have been. Who knows? I don't know. But I know she died. I didn't see the video, but they was talking about how she was trying to get transported. But EMTs trying to transport her through this crowd, and of course the motherfucker started doing, you know, trampling, and they ended up dropping her on her head. She had two heart attacks.
Yeah. Well, that's the girl. She died because she had lost her, like she had lost consciousness, came back, got squashed in it again, and lost consciousness again. So she basically like had 90% of her oxygen to her brain cut off twice.
Damn. Mm. And then, I know, so I've read this and seen articles, too, on the news as far as, like, first responders began to hear of crowd injuries around 9:30 p.m., and the show continued for another 40 minutes, authorities said. And when questions emerged about why the show wasn't stopped, officials said it was not in their power. So, as AC also pointed out, there's a lot of finger-pointing going on. Houston area PD, security professionals, even Travis Scott's camp and manager saying no one is saying they had the authority to stop the show. That's basically what it comes down to. And I even heard that there were some people who said they were afraid to stop the show because they felt that a greater riot may have taken place if Travis Scott wasn't allowed to do his performance.
Well, you know, Travis stopped the show like 3 or 4 times in the middle just when people were out there, like just from what he saw on stage.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah, he actually stopped the show. Like, that's legit. He stopped the show about 3 or 4 times from just things that he could see. But, you know, as an artist, man, on stage with all that, everything, you can't see exactly what's going on.
No, you definitely can't.
Then 100,000 people deep. Like, come on, Bosco. We played in the stadium with 100,000 people before. Do you imagine just 100,000 people surging in one direction?
I remember we played at fucking Ohio State, and we couldn't hear each other talking, dog. Like, we were right there. They had to bring out a fucking white chalkboard to write words down because we could not hear shit. Yep. And that was before they even finished the horseshoe, nigga. So imagine now. I can't imagine how loud that motherfucker is now. But, yeah, man. You know, definitely, you know, to the families, knows the past, man. Hearts go out. And I don't know. Just definitely, hopefully, they figure out something, man. And yeah, this is definitely why.
A finger pointing in this one.
This is definitely why I don't be going to the. And this wasn't even a hood concert. You know, it wasn't. But they be having little hood shows here in Kansas City. I never go there. Nigga, the security is always just a nigga you went to high school with.
Best.
And you like, we all gonna die.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, D, you remember when they the party we went to right before I went to I think it was Bosnia or I can't remember when Jerome and his people had a little show and they started shooting inside the motherfucking venue.
I have no Latham.
Nah, they had it off of 63rd. They had a little community spot over. Yeah, dog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Off of 63rd and Truce.
It's like Manchester.
Oh, okay.
They got a little commute.
I don't remember that. I probably was drunk and fell asleep, nigga.
I don't know. I don't think you were there. Sylvia came with us.
Oh, yeah, the shrine. Yeah. You never supposed to go there.
Yeah,
none.
Yeah, and then I remember somebody said, "Get move, nigga," and they just started shooting inside the party, nigga.
Yo, you know what you're talking about, the Iraq shrine or something where they used to be having them little parties at?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know that. Yeah.
I went because my homeboy, who's a K Kappa, he was having a party there, and at first security was like very strict, and then they're like, oh no, let more people in so we get more money, and it turned very ugly very quickly. Oh shit. All right.
Don't take long.
Do not take long. Where we at here? Ooh, complex. Skip.
I'm Dixie. And I'm Charlie.
Hold on. Skip. All right. So we talked about this last week. We got AC on here, fellow hip hop head, along with all the other brothers here. Did you hear any of the Drink Champs interview, AC?
I actually didn't hear any of the Drink Champs interview on what he said. Run it down. I heard a lot of stuff like about like what he's talking about. So I may have heard some quotes, but didn't realize it was on Drink Champs.
Well, so you know, Nori does a game on the show where he basically you have to, he's gonna give you two choices. You either pick one or two, and it's gonna be hard to pick him because it's gonna be like, you know what I'm saying, somebody gonna feel like they've been put out, or you right. have to take a shot. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. I remember. Okay.
So if you don't choose, that means you gotta take a shot. So a lot of things that you would think would be very difficult for Kanye to choose because they'd be a little, you know, close. This nigga would choose, not only choose a side, but then go into why he chose it, and it would be super disrespectful. You know what I'm saying? So in the first part of the episode that was released last week, he asked some Pusha T or Big Sean, both people on his label, and this nigga was like, "Oh, that's easy as fuck. Look, on my tombstone," he said that what they gonna write on there is the worst business decision I ever made was signing Big Sean.
Okay, yeah. I read that. I didn't know that was on Drink Champs, but I did read that.
Oh yeah, he was going in. Another one, he asked him a Common or Talib Kweli, and he just started trashing Kweli, man. Yep. Like we've seen them do a lot of shit with Kweli. They've been co-collaborators on a lot of stuff.
Right.
I think part of what it is Kweli is the anti-Trump supporter.
Very.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he had been reaching out to Kanye and trying to get in his ear because, you know, he felt like there was a certain amount of closeness, and I think Kanye just wasn't trying to hear it. And mm-hmm. so I think there was a backlash there, and he started talking about how this nigga rhyme. Like, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't about the political ideology. It was about,
right.
Nah, this nigga's a trash rhymer. And like I get saying that, you know, you like Common better, mm-hmm. but to say Kweli trash and you've been quoted as saying, you know, how much you love him and all that type of stuff. Like, he said it in rhymes. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
Well, he was like damn near attached to Kweli's hip at one point.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
And so for him to not only disassociate, like I'm, pick Common, I get it. You know, Chi-Town, he's been very closely linked to Common. You know what I'm saying? Right. They've done albums together.
Right.
But to trash Kweli is a whole different paradigm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He started talking shit about Soulja Boy, and they asked, Soulja Boy was supposed to be on Donda. He asked him, why you ain't put a Soulja Boy verse on Donda? He said, did you hear the verse?
Wow. Like, but he's on brand. Hey, look, he's on brand. That's a fact. Like, that's,
no, absolutely.
That might be the one thing he got right.
Yeah. Okay.
He's going to be on brand. My question is, though, like, in all seriousness with Kanye, like, I know a lot of people speculate, you know, his mama passing and this, that, and everything else. Like, what was the turn, bro? Like, where did we get off at the wrong fucking exit with this guy? Like, what happened? Like, cause I've been trying to pinpoint the whole situation because it's like each year it gets worse and it gets worse and it gets, you know, to a point where, like, literally, I think this dude's gonna run for president, and I think just with how fucked up we are, he just might fucking win.
Well, he already ran for president. He ended up the second episode of Drink Champs with the statement, Kanye 2024.
Wow.
That dragon energy.
Yeah.
I mean,
I tell you, you asked when he turned, we did an episode a few years ago after he went on TMZ.
Yep.
Right.
And we did a deep dive. Like, so he was out here wilding that fuck out on TMZ, and some woman was whispering in his ear, And we was like, who the fuck is this whispering in his ear? It's like, Joe's who the fuck is this bitch?
Joe's boo.
That's when we found out it was Candace Owens. Candace Owens. So that was before niggas knew who Candace Owens was.
Yep.
Okay.
But Candace Owens had got her, you know what I'm saying, sunk her claws into Kanye. And she was basically, you know, putting his hand up his ass and making a mouth move. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Wow.
So he disassociated from her. And has gone his own route. But, I mean, I think he just got into a circle where he was listening to Republicans. I do think it has something to do with his some soul-searching. I think he's wanting to connect with his Christian background, and I think that has something to do with his pro-life stance.
I do, too. I would say, though, I've been skeptical of the Christian stance because what's the easiest way to get most black people on your team?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Like in the church.
Yeah.
Taking the church. So that's always been my theory on that. But my other thing is, so do y'all believe, like, people like Candace Owens and people like that, do you believe, like, I know the media is having them, you know, say certain things, or they're playing to a certain perspective or audience on the media for that. But are they really legitimately, do you feel like these people are legitimately planted, like they're being planted to do this, like planted to try to put themselves within the culture to do this type of shit?
I don't know if Candace Owens is a plant, but I definitely think she sees a money grab.
Yeah.
And she's definitely playing that, because before Trump, she was not this conservative. She was not spouting a lot of the same rhetoric. She had some YouTube channel that was very, like, no one was looking at. And then all of a sudden, she's the spokesperson for anti-blackness, in my opinion. And it just correlates with Trump coming in. And now, once a month, two times a month, she's in the news cycle. So I don't know so much if she's a plant, but like we said earlier, she definitely don't nothing pay like shaming niggas. And if you a nigga that's willing to do it, white people will pay you handedly.
Yes.
Yeah, facts.
And
yeah, I don't have too much to say about it. I'm Kanye'd out, honestly. I didn't hear the second part. The first part was a lot of funny parts in there. But it's just, it was a whole contradiction. The whole interview was contradicting. He talked about having self-worth and doing all this for us as the black people, and we supposed to do this and not lean on it. But you keep name driving. I think something's going on in his head. I'm with you on that. Something's going on. You can kind of tell. But also, one thing he kept saying, and it was real to me, they're going to kill me for saying this. They're going to watch. They're going to kill me. Like, I think he mean that. Like, I really
think he mean that.
No, yeah. Yeah. That's genuine.
But the only thing about Kanye I liked in the past couple of weeks was that Jay Prince, him and that Jay Prince, a video of him reading. Y'all didn't see that?
Yeah, I seen that. They trying to get Hoover out, right?
Yeah, man. It just looked like, remember how we was talking about them eyes when you blink twice if you in trouble?
Hey, dog. Yeah, Jay Prince, that nigga, chill the fuck out.
Oh, my God, man. Kanye was throwing them TikTok signs that the girl had, like, help me, help me.
The second part of the interview that was aired this week featured Larry Hoover Jr., you know what I'm saying, talking a lot about the struggle to get his dad out. And so, I mean, I know that... For me, I think Kanye is just against groupthink. I think he feels like motherfuckers need to work on, you know what I'm saying, just be individuals and think individually. And the shit that Candace Owens says, the Democrats are a plantation. I've said on the show several times, I'm an independent. I vote Democrat because I can't vote Republican right now.
Right. There's no,
but
no.
But I don't fully buy into what the Democrats push either. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, so.
Right. But he go beyond just, I mean, and we talked about before, maybe what he meant to say, but that goes back to what Kyrie made, what he meant to say. When you say slavery is a choice.
Yeah.
I mean, that's beyond groupthink.
That's just, Virginia Tech.
We went over that.
We're still covering. to me, that's beyond groupthink. This nigga just says outlandish shit sometimes, or a lot of times, and just to stay in the side. Because the nigga loves attention, which to me is...
So what he's on, is he's saying, especially with this Larry Hoover shit, is that, you know, he said, hey, we got a black president in, and he didn't do anything for black people behind bars. And you got a black vice president in there, and she was big in terms of incarcerating people in California.
He's talking about Donald that, too, Trump, which is not, as which is not 100%
he
is, true either.
He says that there's some legislation that's passed that is able to give people like a Larry Hoover, you know, a lessened sentence, that type of thing. I don't think that shit weighs out at all.
Right, but once again,
let's have the conversation. I think he's just saying let's have the conversation.
Let's have a conversation.
Don't persecute for me for having the conversation.
But once again, have a conversation. But off top, shit on two black people into your roll up to let's talk or have a conversation.
That's
what I'm saying.
There's a lot of
If you want to have the conversation, exactly. Like the point is, if you want to have a conversation, okay, there's ways to go about having a conversation and being effective with it. But it's like everything with Kanye is part of the promo, bro. Like everything is the promo. Like it doesn't matter whatever it is. It has to be a big spectacle type situation for him to whatever try to get his whole point across.
And he said that.
You know, it's like beyond, it's like extreme, if extreme attention seeking was a sport, this nigga would have the gold medal every year. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy.
He said that.
I had something to say about that, bro.
Who?
Donald Trump.
Well, he sat on his lap, he learned.
No, because they was in competition, and when he was in that nigga office, he damn near did everything except call that nigga daddy.
Yep. That dragon energy. Yeah. And all I'm saying is he might be against groupthink per se. I don't 100% agree with that, but he definitely loves the attention from the group.
He is completely. So here's my thing about that. You remember that Dave Chappelle joke? Which one? Fuck is Ja at a time like this? So, somebody reach out to Ja Rule. I need to find out what Ja Rule think about this.
But the thing is,
somebody reach out to Kanye.
But Kanye,
I don't think this nigga is a great political mind, nigga.
I don't think so either. But
gives a shit.
That nigga keeps reaching. He keep putting himself in the spotlight. I don't give a fuck. I definitely don't care for that nigga.
At all.
Let's be clear. Somebody said he's not a great political mind, but shit, neither is Donald Trump. So that don't make a fuck.
Yeah. Right. He's got a point.
Shit, neither is Biden. For that matter.
Yeah, these things are becoming true.
Hey, bro, you can either step in shit or step in piss. Which one you want to do?
I'm with you. One of them hated us, the other one tolerated us.
I'm just saying. You one of the other.
I like that. I mean, I don't like it because it's true, but I like the same. But no, man. Yeah, I mean, of course, with Kanye, there'll be more to come, and ain't nobody gonna kill that nigga. Good Lord. I mean, Talib, man.
Talib Kweli, man.
Who? Ain't nobody gonna kill no goddamn Kanye West.
Okay.
You think somebody will?
Anything in life can happen, bro. I'm not getting ready to say that he's untouchable or don't nobody want to kill him. Hell, he may opt himself. We know. I don't know.
Yes.
Probably feel like he's a martyr or something. I'm not going to say don't nobody want to kill him. I don't know.
Yes, there are people that want to kill him, I'm sure of it. I'm saying, but ain't nobody killing him just because this nigga on Drink Champs talking shit. That's what I'm
talking
about. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I'm sure there are people out there who want to kill me. Oh, well. I mean, I got – what you think all the guns is for? Nigga, come on through.
I really just think the level of talking he was talking and made him keep saying, like, man, they're going to kill me for saying this. And if I die, man, I think he really believes some of the shit that he's trying to tell us.
Yes.
But he's Kanye, and I definitely ain't going to receive it. Well, even though I do understand what he's saying, I don't give a fuck about it. Like, them people, you know, how everybody was thinking, oh, they got Dr. Sebi and all this type. Now, that's a whole different conversation, but I'm saying that's how he feeling. That's what the level of thinking that he feel he's on.
I agree. He may feel that way, but delusions of prosecution is a real diagnosis.
Yeah, and niggas kill niggas.
Yeah, they do. But once again, I'm not because he's on Drink Champs talking this shit. Yes, I believe he does have a psych. There's something wrong with this nigga. In delusions of persecution, in grandeur, or a thing. DSM-4. I guess 5 now, updated.
Yeah, he creates a lot of his own goddamn persecution, though.
Yeah, yeah. That's why I said delusions of.
Kind of like Kyrie.
Huh? Right. Hey, Kyrie, I ain't heard Kyrie say they're going to kill me.
Oh, okay.
I heard that one.
He said, "I'm just a hooper. I'm just a hooper, man. They feel like they're coming after me, man." Okay.
I mean, they are singling him out. Like we pointed out. I think it's a nigga.
All I'm saying, he's brought some shit on himself. That's all I'm saying.
And we all do. But I'm saying, but the jump on is because he's Kyrie.
That's right. I'm saying.
All right. Well, these are racist people in this church. I don't know. Hold on. We got a video for the fuckery. What not to do if you ever go to a military post?
I'm pregnant. Don't fucking touch me.
You just committed a felony. Get out of the vehicle.
For what? You're not the police.
Yes, we are law enforcement. Step out of the
No, vehicle. You're not. And why did you detain me? You said it was a civil matter. You said it was a civil matter.
I advise you that you're being stopped.
You said it was a civil matter. You said I'm being detained for a civil matter. No.
Step out of the vehicle.
No.
Step out of the vehicle.
No. Don't touch me. Do not touch me. Do not. Why are you doing this? Tell me why. No. So why am I being detained?
Vin, please.
You said it's a civil matter. Get off of me.
Turn around. Put your phone down.
No.
Put your phone down.
I don't have to put my phone down.
Yes, you do. Put your
no,
phone
I
down.
Don't. You're hurt.
She better be glad that was an Air Force base.
What's the setup?
So the setup is... She came to this, and I just want to know it's an Air Force because it says SF, Security Forces. If they're on an Army base, it'd be MP, Military Police. But basically, she pulled up to the gate, had an invalid driver's license. So basically drove past the gate, driving around this military base. I think she may have hit one person. They finally got her pulled over, and that's what ensued. She better be glad she wasn't there. They would have shot them off top. She ran a checkpoint at a military base, and that was the video that ensued. Don't do that, y'all. Please don't.
No.
Fucking throw a grenade in your car. Fuck around.
No, I don't think I've ever been on a military base, honestly.
You don't?
Yeah. What Karen failed to realize is that the military has a different set of laws that they abide by than civilian world. And if you think you're going to run up on a military base, any type of military installation for that matter, and not, you know, reap consequences just by passing a checkpoint, then you're sadly mistaken, Karen.
But, and I will say, she had a child in the back seat, so that may have been the reason why there was a... But we've seen other instances where there are black children in back seats and cars.
Man, once he broke that window, that was it for me. I'm out. Okay, cool. Yeah. My hands is up.
Basically. Hands is up. Don't shoot, nigga. Yeah. Hey, let me get out the car and strip butt naked, nigga, because I want there to be no questions.
I gotta pay for that. You know, I got to pay for that too, man. Fuck it, man. Come on, let's do it.
Yeah, but once again, thank goodness that was an Air Force base because they either Marines or a motherfucking Army base. She got lit the fuck up. Anyway, supposedly there's a racist church out in California. I think we've covered enough foolishness for today, I believe.
Oh, wow.
Damn. Hey, hold on. Not just, people, of course I should have known. People of color and members of the LGBT community are not welcome.
At all. In this neo-pagan, is in their version of the neo-pagan worship.
I don't know. It sounds
like, from Boondocks, the separate but equal Evans with Reagan at the gate.
I mean, and while
we're... That is spot on.
It is.
And you, I don't know why you want to go. It's probably a whole bunch of unwashed legs in this in this congregation. Probably a whole lot of, we only give the babies baths when the dirt is visible.
Yes.
you don't want to go to that.
Believe that swimming counts.
I ain't gonna lie though. They got some outfits though. Yeah. What's that called? LARPing? What's that? The shit where the motherfuckers go out and pretend to be characters and fight with them big ass foam swords and shit?
I guess.
That's what that looked like.
I didn't know that was a thing.
Like out of shape Jon Snow.
Fucking Bob Blizzard, nigga. His fat uncle.
Bob Blizzard.
They, 9,000 years old, Columbia. Oh man, this is a lot going on here. They are the ancestors to Native Americans, so they allow Native Americans to be part of the church?
How?
The bones prove that the white race, his folks, had been in North America first. This is a lot. Okay.
Everything goes back to the Virginia textbook, dog.
That's what it. Yeah. That's what
you want. Yeah, straight up. You going to the Icelandic, fucking Eric the Red type shit?
Yeah, dog. Oh man. You know what? If I was in California, I would go to their church dressed as the Black Panther, nigga, and just be like, "I have come for your gods." Anyway, man, good shit.
Hey, speaking of the Black Panther, I'm sorry, y'all heard about that, huh? About a girl don't want to get vaxxed. I'm sorry.
Well, she don't want to get vaxxed. She's been very vocal about in her anti-vax stance and saying that the vaccination is all a lie and what's crazy is she's saying some of the same shit that white people said in the video we played in the intro.
So we ain't getting Black Panther too.
What'd you say, Joe?
I'm trying to figure out what that got to do with Black Panther.
It's being delayed because they got to recast her role.
Oh, who was it?
The sister, the young sister, who was
word.
Yeah,
Zuri.
Yeah,
she been out here saying some wild shit on the Twitter streets.
And they said that they've already filmed enough of her, but now they really need her, you know, enough without her, but now they need her.
Yep.
And she's like, I don't know what y'all gonna do.
And there's people on the set who don't want her around because she's very vocal in her anti-vax stance. So it's a lot of that going on right now.
Maybe they can get Alec Baldwin to get her on set.
Joe, come through with the hot one. No pun intended. You go, here, hold this gun for me. Oh, wow. Oh, shit. My bad, AC. You almost made it out of the show with no fuckery, but here we are.
Hey, I would expect nothing less, man.
Here we are.
I would expect nothing less.
We good for one, nigga. We good for one.
Oh, man, that was pretty good. Alec. Get Alec. Oh, shit.
Hey, that shit was perfectly timed.
Oh, yeah. 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 One of us come through with one at least at every show, and niggas just gotta blink and just step back from the mic for a second. Hey,
just let me get a rhythm, man. My jump shot ain't here yet. Let me get a rhythm. It'll come.
Yeah, oh, yeah, sir.
Hey, man, I come back when I feed you.
Yeah, well, once you come visit, you can always become a guest, man. Just come on through. Just let us know. Yes, sir. Well, the tabs have been tabulated. Any caveats out there? Anything y'all want to add?
Go get your mental health check.
Definitely. Mental health check.
We have talked about Kanye for like the last 15, 20 minutes. Yes, go get your mental health check.
Mental health check, and then like we do, check in on your people, man. You know what I'm saying? For sure. For sure.
Speaking of which,
move around.
There was a beautiful mug that was posted on the Brothers Breaking Bread page.
Yes. Yes, there were. That mug right now is at work, sitting in the cabinet. But if anyone is interested,
definitely,
they can purchase a Brothers Breaking Bread first ever Brothers Breaking Bread coffee mug.
All right. You need to add that picture to the Facebook and Twitter page. You have to do that.
Yes, I will.
Are you taking special orders? Can I actually get one with the shredder on the other side or something?
And this motherfucker wants something. There will be no
special. Hey, we do have the shredder, the shredder little meme, bro, to go on there, bro.
Yeah. Yeah.
We have that already ready to go.
Yes.
Hey, will it cause any conflicts with trademark if I can get a duck boat on one?
Duck boat shredder, nigga. Let's do it. Uh-oh. All right, man.
It was good.
We got to get up out of here, man. Oh, shit. Hey, thanks for coming through, AC, man. We really appreciate it, bro.
Yes.
Hey, no doubt, man. I appreciate y'all. Have me back whenever, man. I'm always down. If I'm free, I will hop on.
Yes, sir.
Welcome back to the fold.
Yes, sir.
No doubt.
Good to see you, big. I'll give call you, big fella. Good to see you, fella.
He's still way bigger than you. Little guy. Anyway, man. To everyone else, man, thanks for your time. 10 meters. Uncle D, half of the buzz of Doom Joe. Jeff, I'm the KC Stork. Triple B, brothers breaking bread. Never, ever, ever miss a moment to break bread with your brothers. We out.
That mug is nice, man.
Thanks.
I think it's drinking good. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I had to, since they don't have any plastic cups at the job, I said, okay, well, I'll just go ahead and bring in my mug. And then I just went on ahead and made one.
Jeez.
Yeah.
What better
way to have one that kind of represents some of the stuff I do? So
absolutely. Now you just need you a DDB. Triple D mug.
Uh-huh, right.
You said some of the stuff you do. I like, okay, well, you need it.
He needs a shredder on the other side of that mug.
That's what it was. That's the other one. I couldn't remember what the other one was.
God. He just got random pictures of shit on the mug, nigga. Telling a story.
Dude, I knew it was like three things. I couldn't remember what the third one was. The other one was the shredder. I forgot about the shredder, bro.
Hey, dog.
Hey, do it like Brother James do. Put the shredder on the other side or put up like a whole nother mug. If you know, you know.
That nigga need a mute button, triple D, a thing of grapes in the shredder, nigga. All on the mug.
All different mugs, though. They got triple B on the top of it and on the other side.
Oh, it's a collector set. You got to get all four, nigga.
Yeah. Get all four.
But it got to be like watermarked to where it say triple D, though. It might say triple B, but it got to look it, like you hold up against the light and be triple D.
I hate y'all, man. I really do. I'm off this damn podcast, dog. It's my last one.
Shut your ass up.
I'm going to be salty.
You ain't going nowhere now.
Break bread with your brothers whenever possible.